सेशन 29 ऑफ यूनिट 3 ऑफ टैक्सेशन ऑफ फिफ्थ सेमेस्टर बीबीए ऑफ मैंगलोर यूनिवर्सिटी. दिस इज प्रॉब्लम गिवन इन नवंबर 2019. एचयूएफ कंसिस्ट ऑफ 3 मेंबर्स नेमली ए बी एंड सी ऑफ हुम ए इज द कर्ता. From the following profit and loss account of the family and the additional information given below, compute its total income. So profit and loss account is given here. First we have to compute the business income taking into consideration the net profit. Then we have to compute, here we get the rent from house property. This is to compute the income from house property. Interest on government securities, this is regarding income from other sources. Then profit from sale of building, we can get capital gains, winning from lottery, profit from smuggling business, this is smuggling business, winnings from lottery, income from other sources. So among the expenses which are not allowed, we need to add back to the net profit, and also the incomes which are not connected to the business, we need to deduct from the net profit. We need to consider the adjustments given. Salaries included 12,000 paid to A, who is managing the affairs of the family business. General expenses include 2,000 paid as tips to police and 1,000 paid as penalty, both relating to smuggling business. Life insurance and municipal taxes relate to house property let out. Building, a block of assets, written down value rupees 80,000, sold for rupees 1 lakh during the year. Depreciation allowable on other block of assets is 3,800. Collection charges include 20 for collection of interest on government securities and the balance for collection of rent from house property. We have collection charges here, 200 rupees. Now let us see how to compute this total income of HUF. Now here we have combined all the five heads of income. So computation of total income. First we have computed. We can also compute the business income separate and then we can combine the other heads. But in this problem we have combined all the heads together. So first income from house property. Rent from house property 12,000 less municipal taxes paid 600, so annual value will be 11,400 less 30% of annual value, 30% of 11,400, it comes to 3,420. So the income from house property is 7,980. Therefore three amount columns are provided here. Next is income from business. Net profit as per profit and loss account is considered here, 12,55,000. We have to add back all the items which are not allowed, which are not connected to the business. So income tax 4,200, provision for doubtful debts 3,000, fire insurance 400, municipal tax 600, household expenses 18,000, donation 2,000, collection charges 200, depreciation 1,000, this item will be given in the adjustment. General expenses 3,000, these are not connected to the business. So if we add this together, it comes to 32,400. When we add, the net profit increases to 12,087,400. We have to deduct the incomes not related to business, like rent received, interest on government securities, profit from smuggling business, profit on sale of building, and winnings from lottery. So these items we shall add together and deduct from the net profit. So the net profit 12,87,400 minus 61,200. Therefore the income from business is 12,26,200. Therefore this is income from business. Now profit from smuggling business, it is 8,000 rupees. This is under the business head, but from no, it is speculation business. Next is capital gain, short-term capital gain, sale of building 1 lakh, less written down value is 80,000. So short term capital gain is 20,000. Income from other sources, winnings from lottery, 11,200. Interest on government securities, 8,000. Less collection charges, so it comes to 7,980. Therefore, total other sources are 19,180. So we get the gross total income 12,81,360. Less deductions under Section 80. Section 80G, donation to college. Maybe this is a recognized college, therefore deduction at the rate of 50% deduction. 50% of the amount we get as the deduction, that is rupees 1,000. And if we subtract this, we will get the total income 12,80,360. Now let us see the November 2020 problem. The following details have been furnished by the karta of HUF: profit from business, salary received by a member of the family for services elsewhere, rent from let out property, municipal tax paid, annual municipal value for construction of house property, interest on loan taken for the house 30,000. These are income from house property we require for the calculation of income from house property, dividends from company, income from other sources, directors fees received in personal capacity, interest on bank deposit, long term capital gain under capital gains, donation to government for family planning. So this amount is qualified for 100% deduction. Salary received by karta from the firm for his services, share of profit from firm which is exempt from tax, medical insurance premium by check 8,500 under Section 80D we get deductions, advance tax paid from the tax liability we have to deduct this 1,000, so that we arrive at net tax liability, insurance premium paid on LIC policies qualified for deduction under Section 80C. Income tax officer has found 10,000 paid as salary to a member of the family as unreasonable. Depreciation was found to be in excess by 2,000. So this item we need to adjust with the business income. So let us compute the total income and net tax payable. Computation of total income. So first is house property. In that self-occupied house property, we get the annual value nil, but there is interest on housing loan 30,000. So there is loss from house property 30,000. Let out property, rent received is 12,000. Municipal tax is 1,000. So annual value is 11,000. Less standard deduction at the rate of 30% on 11,000, 3,300. So income from house property is 7,700, that is from let out property. Profits from business 3,10,000. Add salary which is unreasonable and depreciation which is in excess 2,000. So we get the profit from business 3,22,000. Long term capital gains is 25,000. Income from other sources, directors fees as well as interest on bank deposits, comes to 28,000. Gross total income is 3,52,700. Now the deductions under Section 80, LIC 51,000, medical insurance 8,500, and donations for family planning 100%. So total deductions is 67,820 and the total income is 2,84,880. Now let us compute the tax liability on the total income. On the long-term capital gain, which is 25,000, at the rate of 20%, comes to 5,000. On the balance, so 25,000 we need to deduct from the total income, we get the balance 2,59,880. On the first 2,50,000, tax is nil, and on the balance 9,880, tax at the rate of 5%. So the total tax is 5,494 plus health and education cess 4% on the tax payable, 5,494. Therefore, it is 220 and therefore tax payable is 5714. We are deducting advance tax paid 1000 rupees. So the balance of tax payable or net tax liabilities 4714, which can be rounded off to nearest rupees 10, rupees 4710. These are the references used